Mr. Hogue, just to kind of get started, kind of a warm-up question. When did you first become aware that you could make people laugh?
Well, I think when I was here in New York, and I was doing an act, a dancing act, and one day I went in down in the subway and stuck my head out to look for the train, and that was the first laugh I got. And I've been funny ever since.
Is it true that you really started doing comedy by accident?
No, not really. I did a dancing act with my dancing partner, a girl in Cleveland, and we used to do little jokes in between dances. And that's when I started. Then I started the first tab show I was on, which was a tabloid musical comedy, which was very popular back in those days. I did everything on that show. I did blackface comedy, and I did all styles of comedy and all styles of everything on the stage, singing and dancing. That's actually how I started. And what I think what you're referring to is the thing in Newcastle, Pennsylvania, when the manager asked me to announce, this is when I started my single act, asked me to announce the show that was coming in. And I went out and started doing a monologue. And I'd add a joke or two every time, and finally the manager of the theater said, that's the kind of act you should do, you this dancing act. It doesn't compare with those laughs you get standing up. And that gave me the idea to do my single act, so I broke up the double act and went and started doing comedy.
From the time you began doing comedy, how long did it take you to become aware of the kind of jokes that fitted you and your personality best?
Well, I think that was developed in the next maybe 3 or 4 or 5 years. I started I got my first break in Chicago at the Stratford Theater where I was doing Master of Ceremonies, and we used to have to change in midweek. So I did 2 shows a week, and I needed a lot of material. And if a vaudeville act would come in, I'd say, do you have any jokes, know any jokes that I could tell? And so I used to do all kinds of dialect jokes and anything, and used to scrape them up from reading college humor and switching jokes and working and, trying to get just material to do. And it was a great thing, this job, because I used to have to save jokes. Jokes that didn't play so well, I had to play with the audience to save them,
How long were you at this particular...
I was there about 6 months at the Stratford Theater in Chicago. And the audience got to know me, and when I started to do a dialect joke, I'm probably the worst dialectician of the world, and as soon as I started to tell a joke, an Irish joke or a Jewish joke, they used to laugh before I'd get into the punchline because I was so bad telling it, But it was a whole big thing. It was like working to your family because it was the same audience all the time. They'd just come back. They knew you. They liked you, So you had the sympathy, thank God.